The Philippine economic team makes a case why the country is a compelling destination of choice for investors during the Philippine Investors Dialogue held in Washington, D.C. on Wednesday. Manila's economic managers highlighted efforts to improve the investment climate in the country, including reforms to streamline government processes and prudent fiscal management. They also touted the accelerated rollout of the Marcos administration's infrastructure program, which is valued at over $160 billion. NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan said the Philippine government continues to with its proactive approach in seeking out investment and trade opportunities despite various external risks. The Philippine government eyes distributing 100,000 land titles to farmers this year. That commitment made by Agrarian Reform Chief Conrado Estrella at a public briefing Thursday. He says his agency has so far distributed some 15,000 land titles to agrarian reform beneficiaries this year. Estrella says farmers also get other support from their operations as ordered by President Marcos.
Ang utos ng ating Pangulo ay hindi lang sapat na lupa ang ating maipamigay sa mga ating mga agrarian reform beneficiaries. Kanya sabi niya, kailangan bigyan natin sila ng mga support services katulad alimbawa ng farm to market roads at napakarami nang naibigay natin. Kaya yung iba natapos na, yung iba kasalukuyan ginagawa yung kanilang mga farm to market roads. Pagkatapos pangalawa na mabigyan natin sila ng farm machineries and equipment. Hindi lang tungkol sa farming, hindi lang tungkol sa pagsasaka ang gusto niyang masuportahan ng ating magsasaka. Pati na ang kanilang kabuhayan, karagdagang kabuhayan, ang kalusugan, at ang kinabukasan ng kanilang mga anak.
An ambitious effort aiming to provide electricity to 300 million people in Africa in the next 6 years now underway. Leading the charge, the World Bank and African Development Bank Group. The World Bank will work to connect 250 million electricity through distributed renewable energy systems or the distribution grid, while the African Development Bank will look to provide energy to the other 50 million. The World Bank estimates $30 billion of public sector investment will be needed for the project. Currently, some 600 million Africans lack access to electricity. State Weather Bureau PAGASA warns temperatures, especially in Luzon, will likely continue rising, especially during the month of May. According to PAGASA's Climate Monitoring and Prediction Section Chief Ana Solis, there's a possibility that parts of the Philippines will experience a heat index of 52 degrees Celsius and above in the coming weeks. She urges caution as these dangerous conditions put the public at risk of heat strokes.
Historically kasi, medyo ang matataas nating temperatura na iitala during the months of April as well as during the months of May. Kaya dito nakikita natin na possible pa rin na patuloy na iinit at tataas ang ating temperatura. Pagdating ng Mayo, asahan po natin lalo na dyan sa may parte ng Cagayan Valley area, dyan po sa may parte ng Isabela, ng Cagayan, pati na po dyan sa may Ilocos region, medyo maiinit din po. Kasama na po dyan yung sa Central Luzon area and also itong mga karatig na mga probinsya ng Metro Manila, dyan po sa Batangas, Cavite, na medyo coastal areas